Hey folks, this is Noble Rambler and welcome to another episode of Farming Simulator 17. We're in Goldcrest Valley and last two episodes ago we had a poll trying to decide if we're going to dive into cattle or pigs or logging or just sit here and play with the lights in the tractor. But cattle is what was chosen. So we are officially ranchers. We're into the cattle business now. But let's go pick up the trailer, the animal transport trailer. I'm sure there's an official name for it, but that's all I've got right now. Right there with the yellow top. And let's go pick up as many cattle as this guy will let us haul. Then we'll toss some feed in there and maybe pick up a second load. We'll see how far the budget goes. That's right. This one's always kind of deceiving to me because all the hydraulic hookups are right there on the back left, or I guess from the back it'd be on the right. It's the little silver guy in the very center that I'm aiming for. So right in there. Okay. So off to Mary's farm again. That's kind of where we ended last episode. So we're going to go this way. It's quieter from inside the cab, but to me it just looks better out here. I can see more of what's going on. But it is quieter in here. But you can see more out there. Oh, there's so many blind spots in these tractors. There we go. I'm trying to remember how many cattle this trailer will haul. I'm thinking that it is six. I think it was something like 10 sheep, 9 pigs, and 6 cows or something like that. So probably two of these trailers full will get us going. A dozen cattle. We've got to get the straw bale shredder bought and brought over. And the total mixed rations food mixer brought over, which isn't a big deal because it's right there near the cattle ranch area. So that shouldn't be too time consuming. And again, we've got weathering turned off, so this crop of sunflowers here that have been waiting to be harvested forever is just going to sit there forever. Until I need some serious money, I'll come over here and do this for her. Big cow on the building over there. That's where we're going. All right. R? Yes. So, pigs, doesn't it say, of 9, sheep of 10, cows of 6. Yep, that's how it goes. So let's grab 6 of 6. Going to cost us $30,000. Confirm. Can we choose the color? Yes. Reloaded? Reloaded. Here we go. $30,000 negative. New livestock. Try to keep these corners somewhat smooth and not too crazy. And we're heading in that direction. Yeah, we're not heading back home this time. So this field has got that shed over there for storing items, storing machinery. This field over here has got this this big setup right here to our left. So there's storage out here. Let's see, best way is probably out over here. field's got one too over there. So lots of storage built out in these fields that are far away from the farm. Yeah, we're pretty close to town here. Just gotta figure out how to access the main road. Can we travel through this? No. Oh, let me just go straight to the cow farm. Okay. Now, loading. That's food or water over there. I think loading is right here. Right in that space. What is... That's interesting. The gate's over there. Oh well. Looks like they intended you to pull in along the fence right there. We'll do that next time. At this point, I believe all I have to do is get the back end into that square. It's good enough. Yeah, so let's unload. New. Okay, I guess that's right. Yeah, I was expecting something a little different, but 0, 6, and 6. Confirm. And magically, they're in place. So 30, let's go get one more load. Sure. Let's do a little compacting while we're at it. Should be quite a bit of weight. So I'm going to spread it out, especially here at the end. Nope, maybe it's fully compacted already. Okay, one more trip. And trailer's empty, so it's pedal to the metal through here. There's the diner. We'll go this way. I'm going to have to try to remember the combination for the total mix of rations. This isn't it, is it? That's not looking right. Nope, that's not it. All right, let's keep that one, little mini-map on the screen there. It goes up to a campground or something. I like the sound it makes when I slow down and speed up again. Lots of controls in here. I'd love to spend time inside of a real one. But a little bit out of my budget. It's above my pay grade. The best way to turn this guy around is probably right into a stall. Now, would it let me back up the ramp? Just for fun. I'm guessing that's still within the rectangle. Question is, can I? Yeah, not bad. Yeah, let's see what happens. Yep, that worked. Buy 6 more? No. Right there. There we go. And boy, if I had done that. We'll be immediately reselling them. Confirm 6 cows, yes. Alright. Let's go make this happen. So can we see them back there? Yep. Alright, so this time we'll try and pull in the way that they seem to indicate. Something along these lines. Alright. Just got to thinking, we don't have any hay or grass bales left, do we? Unload. And confirm. We've now got a dozen cattle out there. Okay. We got straw, and we've got silage. We don't have grass or hay. Yes, we do. All that meticulous stacking over there at the sheep. Uh-huh. Well, let's see. I wish I knew the exact combination I needed. The total mixed rations is 2 of 1 and 1 of 2. Something like that. Basically 1 of each of 3, but 1 of those 3 is doubled. I'm just trying to remember which one it was. Let's take this home. How do we want to do this? Let's go buy the mixing wagon. Let's do that first. In which case, I think we'll just park this in the parking lot for now. Which means... next turn, right? Yeah. Do a pull through parking space over here. You would do if you had a truck and trailer going to the grocery store. But we'll head over and grab this one since I was out of the lines there. Yeah, something like that. Alright, so we're looking for animals. There they are. This guy takes straw bales and basically shreds them to be a ground cover. This guy is a mixing wagon. Blends silage, hay, straw. What I'm wondering is, do we haul this over to the sheep real quick and use the Manitou to drop 2 bales in? We could, I believe, activate it and blow some of that back out before we add the other 2 in. But we need a front loader over at the cattle area now, too. So I'm going to have to drive several things in several different directions at once. Okay. Let's just get this guy. Select no upgrades available. Buy. Yes. And... okay, now there were 2 choices. I guess I didn't go any further. This is the bigger one. We're not budgeted for this guy, but this guy you can mix it up and drive it where you want, and I believe just deposit it right into their feeding trough Whereas this one, you've got to have a trailer to drive it around. This is like a almost like the Manitou in the way, you know, you sit off to the side and this probably lifts up and down. Don't know if it extends. But that's where we're at. I guess we can get this guy bought as well and just have it sitting out there. All right. Let's be sure to grab the right one. We want the mixer. So we are at $60,000 now. I think we're done buying for this little adventure. So once we get to working on it, right there. Top one is hay. Grass will work as well. Middle one is silage. And lower one is straw. So it looks like it wants less straw and more hay and silage. But catching it right in the center of all those is tough. You never really get it centered. You get one to the extreme one end, one to the extreme other end, but they're still barely within the minimums that it makes it. It's kind of an odd combination. You'd think that, you know, it would be sized just right so that the size bale that the game uses would line up perfectly, but that's not the case. I guess, let me assume it's not the case in real life. This is the actual equipment that's out there, and of course in real life you can walk out there and cut up a bale into pieces and toss in what you want. Can't really do that here. Let's grab two grass bales and bring this back. And then we'll go grab one of the case tractors. Whoa, with the front loader arms attached. And use that to grab the straw bale shredder and bring that over. And we'll have that then to be able to load up the straw and silage into the mixing wagon. Come on, folks. Sheep. Oh, sheep. I didn't have to go this way. I could have gone right in there from the other way. Oh, well. We'll make up some time by cutting across our field. Freshly fertilized field. Let's fertilize it one more time before, let's see, how best to do this. I guess we'll just pull into here before we actually mow it. We'll fertilize it again. I got that bucket right where I would want to pull in, huh? Let's do this then. We'll load them in this way. Right? Not really. See if we can do something more like that. There we go. I'm happy with that. Alright, this guy. Oh, what was I going to do? I was going to check something. I was going to check something. Let's do this real quick. Fertilizer. That was it. Now, it's showing red because it needs to be plowed, but you can click this guy, and it turns off the plowing so we can see what's going on. And he's at stage number 2. For some reason, it was already the lightest stage. I guess because we didn't have the opportunity to reseed it. So maybe it stays in that stage. That's possible. So if we fertilize it one more time as it hits the last layer of growth, it should give us almost double the grass we got out of the last one. A lot more bales, a lot more silage out of it. So I think that'll be worthwhile. That's not it. Too many new buttons on this new keyboard. Okay, so this guy, let's do that. Head out and turn around. How do I can't. I have to get out of here. I can't get down any lower. There we go. I'm ducking my head here while I'm playing the game. All right, so let's figure this out. You're there, and yes, you're a sheep. Boy, there's some jaws on you. Tell you what, let's grab the top two at the same time. Whoa, let's try that again. Something like that. Zoom in here. Want to grab pretty low so that the bale fork doesn't slam the roof. But maybe to there? Alignment-wise, that's pretty close. In fact, no, I cannot extend. That's right. I've got to just drive it. All right. Gotcha. So just tilt a little, up a little. We're hitting the roof. Can I get out of here without dragging the pile with me? Looks like I'm clear. Okay, good. Now, I'm pretty sure I do not need two of these, but I might be wrong. I didn't want to get there to find out that was wrong. So I'm going to bring two. I think I can eject part of one if I need to. All right, so if we were to just... Yeah, that's how it works. Okay. Just wondering if that hitch right there could handle the straw bale shredder. It can't power it, but it could maybe haul it. So I'd rather use this over there at the cattle. Now there is a mod called Follow Me where I could set this guy up to follow that tractor over there, the Massey Ferguson in, and it would be as if you're hiring someone to drive it for you. But I don't have that installed. I've never used it before, and last thing I want to try to do is learn it live. So I'm going to... I think I'm going to just... drive this one back. Hop up in there. And we'll toggle back over and grab this guy. And we'll find out if that works or not. If not, we're not that far away from the cattle to the store. We can use this tractor to go get it if we have to. But we have to have something that can pick up a bale of hay. I'm just curious. All right, so 100% of what we got in here is grass or hay. As we add other ones in, that percentage will drop down. So we're needing, if you look at it as percentages, we're needing, I'm going to say, up to 25% of straw. And somewhere between 20 and maybe 80% of the other two, meaning 21 and 79, still work. It's still within that range between the arrows. So that's how you kind of meter your way into this. Let's get this guy back and then figure out what to do with the Manitou. But that way we can leave it. We can leave the Manitou over there for at least for now. And not lose one of our tractors for whenever the next round of harvesting comes up. Harvesting and cultivating and sowing and all that stuff happening at once. And we're not going that way. Gotta get it in my mind, we're going this way. Trying to remember how this guy dumps the food out. We're going to the cattle, which is up here. I don't know if there's a pipe that extends. I'm trying to remember how that works. It's been a while since I've done this. I haven't done it in Farming Simulator 17 yet. Clear that way and this way. Second left. So let's just park this guy where it's convenient. Jump the curb there. And soon we should start seeing this stuff come to life. Slurry and manure. Oh joy. What a joyous day that will be. So let's assume I'm exiting out this silo here. Let's do that. All right, so let me just tab over to this guy and drive him. We're going to do it this way. All right, I'm going to get inside because this guy's really squirrely. But let's go and try to pick up the straw bale shredder. There. Got my Mad Max mobile here. That sounds like such a tiny little engine compared to the Massey Ferguson. The glorified go-kart under the hood here. Sounds like a Yugo. Clear. And the store. Alright, what kind of hitch has this got? With the flat pin? It looks like it. This should work. Okay. Where am I headed on this? Ah, it's the mirror. That's right. Ah. There is a challenge. Can I even see any of it come in to view? Where are you? I'm expecting a crunch any second now. Okay, I'm getting out of the car to look at it. Yeah, I missed it. Alright. One more time. I'm going to turn that way. There you are. Ooh. Nailed it. Alright. We're hooked up and... what did I do? I dropped the hook. Okay, so much for that. He won't attach. He won't attach. Nope. Okay, well, and this guy is now upside down. I have a feeling we're going to be flipping through the air like being hit by a giant in Skyrim here in a second. When I hook that up and it swings almost 90 degrees into the ground. What do you want to bet? Here we go. Nope. It didn't go crazy. Okay. Physics weren't too whacked out on me. Okay. To the cattle. Take our Mad Max mobile and chase people around. There's Worker G. That's their names in this game. Alright, we're off in this direction somewhere. I think it's still a block or two to the left. Yeah, right down there. Clear, clear. Let's go ahead and get this part of it done. We've got our two hay. Let's see. That's this way and this way. Boy, that looks weird from inside. And, yeah, I'm not about to tackle that one. I know we only want one straw. I don't want to tackle it from the cab. I'll just end up knocking all of our piles over. But let's get lined up to about like that. Alright, straight up, something like that, only want one, I'm in, no I'm not, he's shaking in fear with me just getting near him. Okay, you're there, so we'll put one of each of these in there, then I'll decide if I need to get rid of some grass or not. There we go. We're getting there. It's looking better. Alright, let's grab a silage. So now you see why I saved a stack of all these. Though I didn't think about saving a stack of hay. I should have. Alright, right. Boy, it looks so different. Here it looks like I'm heading right into the middle of that bale. From here, I'm missing it completely. Alright, there. And down. Like that. See if we can spear that thing. Alright. Tip it up. This way. Alright. There we go. Now you'd think that you'd have to be able to take the wrapper off of this, but I guess it's just simulating, assuming that you did take it off. Okay, so that's all that's going to fit in there. I guess this guy just lives right in here. And next time we get a chance to get some hay bales or grass, well, hay bales probably the best. We'll park him in that back corner over there. Anyway, drop this guy down so that it's not sitting on the hydraulics. Something like that. And let's see if our mixture is within boundaries here. We made it. So 50, 25, 25 makes it. I'm guessing it could have been either way. Either two silage and one hay or two hay and one silage. Would have given you the opposite results, but it still would have fit within the boundaries. Okay, how does this work? Turn on mixer wagon is B. So I'm guessing it dumps out this black plate right here. And it just automatically dumps out the one that I see the hydraulics right in there. Open up. Looks like they lift up a door right there. A floodgate. But it looks like it would dump to both sides. Well, I guess we'll just we're going to drive through. Zoom out a little. Continue our compacting whenever we get a chance. Let's see. Does it tell us? Compacted 7%. It is doing it. But it's doing it really slow compared to the other one. Like, the numbers are not the same between here and the biogas plant. Compacting was so much faster with the same tractor. Alright, supposedly right in here, we can start to unload, which I've already forgotten. Is it I? Tip side. I didn't see that before. Okay, that's how you determine it. Tip side is going to be right. Left and right. Nothing changes on the wagon, though, when I do that. Now. Okay, right, and then turn on is B. Getting where we can see this. Okay, what did that do? Alrighty. So I guess, in a sense, that's mixing. Okay, I is for unload. And now we're dumping in. Kind of dumping on the ground, but that's the idea. There. And it's going to put out the amount that 12 cattle need, which is probably going to be more than this guy can produce in one load, huh? Interesting. Alright, so turn them off. Where are you at? B? Okay. So out of curiosity, where is it at? Where are we? Animals. Cows. So hay and silage part of it. Now grass, it actually is grass, not hay. Okay, so we do need some grass to be brought over here. Need to get water over here and straw over here. Okay, so I'll tell you what. We're at about 40 minutes right now. We'll make the great cattle episode a two-parter. I'm going to call this one done right here. And when I get back, I'll just continue recording. And we'll get everything else done. Water, straw, do a quick mowing somewhere, get some grass, bring that over, that sort of thing. So this has been Noble Rambler. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll catch you next time, folks. Bye-bye.